Hawaii's most populous island, the island of Oahu, is known for many things. Its scenery, its ocean wildlife, and military history, with the last thing you'd expect to occur here is a volcanic eruption at some point in the future. After all, that's something that can only happen on the Big Island and less frequently on Maui, right? Wrong. As, due to a peculiar quirk of Hawaiian geology specifically, future volcanic eruptions on the island of Oahu are technically possible, even despite the fact that its last Shan volcano ceased building 1.5 million years ago. As, around parts of Oahu, there are numerous far younger volcanic vents such as the famous Diamond Head Tuff Cone, which formed an explosive eruption, or the Coco Head Crater, which formed a mere 50,000 years ago, quite geologically recently. And Coco Head doesn't even represent the youngest volcanic eruption to have occurred on Oahu. Regardless, the island's last volcanic eruption occurred tens of thousands of years ago, so why might I say a potential could exist for future volcanic activity? Specifically, an unexpected occurrence in 1956. As, on May 22, 1956, the crew of a U.S. Navy plane were flying between the islands of Oahu and Kauai when they observed an unusual sight. A patch of brownish-yellow material was present in a section of the ocean measuring more than 1,000 feet wide. As they got closer, a strong sulfur odor was detected by the crew. What had just occurred was a submarine volcanic eruption in an area thought to be completely void of volcanic activity. Although this eruption cannot be necessarily linked to the island of Oahu, it may have occurred at the Kaena volcano, which was the first of three volcanoes to form part of the overall island. The reason why this likely volcanic eruption occurred and why Oahu has such young volcanic features relates to a somewhat unexpected phase of volcanism that occurs long after a specific shield volcano has ceased erupting, sometimes even millions of years later. This is known as rejuvenation stage volcanism. The Hawaiian Islands represent a volcanic hotspot chain that were fed by hot rising material in the mantle known as a hotspot. This hotspot largely stayed stationary while the overlying Pacific tectonic plate drifted to the west-northwest. Volcanoes form and erupt closest to the hotspot epicenter at the highest rate and erupt at a lower and lower rate the further from the plume's center they are, being fed by the plume tail until a point after which they become inactive. During this process, the crust, the islands, and the volcanoes are floating on top of the mantle. The thicker the crust becomes, say, for example, due to a thick volcanic island growing on it, the more it sinks down into the mantle. This subsidence generally continues until such large volumes of overlying island erode away until uplift starts to occur. When this uplift begins, it decreases pressure on the underlying mantle material, causing limited amounts of decompression melting to occur. This magma can then rise to the surface and produce one or more volcanic eruptions. The rejuvenation stage volcanism continues until the rate of uplift dramatically decreases or the potential material that could undergo decompression melting has already melted. Eruptions during these stages can sometimes occur more than 150,000 years apart, and in the case of Oahu, the rejuvenation stage volcanism known as the Honolulu Volcanics began intermittently erupting 800,000 years ago. Eruptions occurred in clusters in differing small rifts of sorts, with the earliest cluster occurring on Oahu's northeast 5 miles southwest of the Mokopu Peninsula. Eruptions were primarily explosive and brief. Rising magma would encounter large amounts of groundwater or a section of shallow ocean. The magma would then heat the overlying water to such a degree that it flashed a steam. Since the steam took up far more volume than the water it once was, it built in pressure and then violently exploded upwards. Pyroclastic flows or surges were frequently generated, and hours to days-long eruptions of repeated explosions of this nature created what is known as a tuff cone. However, if rising magma did not encounter any large volumes of water, it erupted effusively, forming short to medium-distance lava flows on occasion. Here are the ages of a few of these vents along with their vent types. And now, here are the ages of the five youngest volcanic eruptions to occur in the Honolulu Volcanic Series. As you can see by my attempt at modeling the West Maui Shield Volcano, which also underwent rejuvenation stage volcanism, such eruptions are infrequent and low in volume. They can occur long apart from each other, and in the case of the Honolulu Volcanics, it would seem that the rejuvenation stage either ended 35,000 years ago, or will in the geologic timescale soon end. Thus, while a future rejuvenation stage type volcanic eruption is technically possible since these eruptions occurred an average of once every 20,000 years, such a future eruption seems highly unlikely.